Okay, so when creating a small Flutter project, you don't really need to worry about file structure or that much organization because you're probably the only one working, maybe one more person, but you know what's going on at all times. It's pretty easy. But when you get into larger projects, file structure is very, very important. It makes the code easier to maintain, it makes it more organized, and definitely better for teamwork. For example, if a team member is working on one part of the app, you can be working on the other part of the app, and you guys will not need you not have any problems working together on different parts. So the main section of this video will definitely be in the lib part, but I wanted to mention the couple folders that I have in the root directory of the app, I guess, and it's these three right here. The assets folder is just assets of the app. For example, any images. These are also static assets, those that won't change. It's not like you're getting them from the network or anything. It's just stuff that is on the app and will be on the app. So logos is a great example of this. Your logo is not going to change. You're probably going to have it throughout the app. And icons, etc. Things like that. That's where I put all my assets. Very simple to keep track of. You don't have to go looking through all your folders. Next thing, which most of you might not need to change, but I have had to change in some of my apps, is a fonts folder. So when the Flutter starts, the default font in Flutter is called Roboto. If you want to use any other font, I would recommend you put it in a folder. If you have multiple fonts, I would definitely recommend doing that then, so you can keep track of all your fonts and everything that's going on. This functions is cloud functions for me. If you're not using Firebase, this one might not be necessary, but I use Firebase for most of my apps, and I store all my cloud functions here. They use different code, everything when you need to push the functions onto the database. You know, everything's in your root directory, like it's just a lot easier. For these two, assets and fonts, these will be mentioned in your pubspec.yaml, and then you will be able to use them throughout the app very easily. So let's get into the lib folder. That's the most important folder of a Flutter app, right? So here's the structure of my lib folder. Main thing you have is your screens. Screens are pretty self-explanatory. In this example, we'll have two screens, a home and a second screen. For every screen that you have in the app, you should have a screen folder. I have my home folder here, and I have my second folder. The file in here is the actual layout of the screen. This should have your scaffold or whatever else you're using instead of that. Local widgets, if it's a small screen, might not be necessary. But I like to have a widgets folder, for example, if you have a really big widget in one of your screens. Let's see, maybe like a big table or maybe tabs or something bigger. You definitely want to put it in the widgets. Bigger widgets. So one of the key parts here is the local widgets should contain widgets that are only used once throughout the app. If you use a widget more than once, I would recommend you put it in a widgets folder. Widgets folder contains widgets that are used throughout the app. So let's say, for example, an app bar. Let me just write this down. Widgets used throughout app. One easy example is the app bar. You have it defined once in the widgets folder. If you change something small, you'll change it once here. It'll be updated on both screens. If you have a lot of screens, you definitely want to be doing this since, like, Let's say you want to change something in the app bar. You'll have to go through every single screen. You might forget one screen, then one app bar doesn't match all the other app bars, and your whole app just looks like a mess. That's not what you want, right? Another folder I have is called utils. These are for functions that are used throughout the app. One example I can think of off the top of my head, let's say you have a login screen and you have a username, right? And then let's say you have a button to sign up. So this username will go through validation, right? We need to be more than four characters, let's say, more than four characters or something like that. Pretty simple, right? But then you go to the sign up screen. You go to a sign up screen. You have the same username. And you need it to be more than four characters again. Why make two functions when you can just make it once and use it from the utilities folder? Pretty simple. Let me give you a couple more examples of what I have used for both of those. So for utils, I have used validation. That's a big one. I've used time since function to calculate how much time has elapsed since the time you input. Image capture. Let's say you have a social network app. You want to take a picture on a profile page of yourself or whatever, and you want to take a picture when you're creating a post. Why use two different functions when you can use one? It's a lot easier. And then theme is also something that I put in there. As far as like the widgets that I have used for big things, app bar, if you're creating a social network, posts. So you want to have the same post layout for everything. Text fields. Let's say you want them all your text fields throughout the app to look the same way. You want them all to have this certain color of highlighting, something like that. Why not do it once where you could change it once and it'll be updated throughout the app simply? Come on. All right. Then also we have services. Only thing I've really used it for is for Firebase, but the reason I put it in a separate folder is so you have your app, correct? My app. And then you have Firebase. Do you want to be getting this Firebase from every single page I use it for? You're probably going to be using it a lot if you're using Firebase. Do you want to do it from every single page, or do you want something that handles all of that? So you have a nice little services that interacts with Firebase and back. And all you do is you just call your services. And if you need to change anything, you just have to change it once in the services. Lastly, we have models. Models are just collections of data. Collections of data. This helps to organize the code just to make it look nicer. I'll give you a couple examples. User data is one that I've used a lot. You want to have the name, the ID of the user, their email, things like that. Stored under one object, and everything's just simpler. You have everything that you need. Another example is if you're doing something with a social network, you have posts, right? That's not going to work. You have posts, you have user that posted, you have the image, description, time, whatever. You can keep going. And it's all under one object. You have access to all of it. Everything's organized throughout the app. The main is the last thing. I don't even know if that needs to be covered, but the main is obviously going to be the entry point of your app. Through this, this is where I usually set up my navigation. And then navigate through your screens, and then the rest of your app can handle all that stuff. That's pretty much it. Now let me go over it with you one more time of all the things inside the lib. We have the models, which are collections of data. We have screens, which are just screens of the app. I don't know if there's a better way to explain that, but hope you guys know what a screen is. Services, which are interactions outside of app. Another use for services that I forgot to mention is, for example, you have any APIs that you're using. This is definitely where that should go. Then you have your utils folder, utilities. These are functions used throughout the app. And finally, widgets are just widgets. Jeez. Used throughout app. And that's how I organize almost all of my apps. I would even do this for smaller projects, just because you get into a good habit of keeping your code organized altogether. But thanks for watching. If you have any questions, make sure to leave it in the comments. I'll try to make videos about how to actually implement these, so you can see how I go through my code with it. But that's it. Make sure to like and subscribe. And again, thanks for watching.